experiment.
Now we are performing the experiment called sonometer. We have seen this apparatus already. This is sonometer. Now our aim is to find the transverse wave moving, traveling along the length of the string with what velocity. So our aim is to find the velocity of transverse wave along this rigid string. Now can you say why this wire is stretched like this? So first of all, we are tying here one end of the wire, and this is a brass wire, and this brass wire is passing through the second pole, and then it is freely falling on the pulley, and at the other end we are suspending mass. Here each one is 500 grams. So here we are hanging 1, 2, 3 and the fourth one. See, look at the fourth one. With the hook itself, it is also 500. So 4 500s we are adding. So it means 2000 grams or 2 kg gram we are suspending. So this is why we have the suspension. Now these two are the bridges. And please do remember, we have to place the bridges at the center of the scale. Already the scale is fixed at the two sides of this. Then box. Then we are placing it as close as possible. Two bridges. And then place the riders. You don't press the riders much, so they are in the shape of V. Okay? Right? Now you take the same tuning fork set, out of which you select any one of the tuning fork which is in working condition. Hope you know how to do the working condition. So you take the other one. It is 480 working or 380 working, 340 working. So this is 340 volts. Now we are exciting and placing between this. So what happens? This vibrating body we are placing between these two, where it is resting on these two edges. Then vibrations also will start setting up in that suspended wire under some tension. Now if we excite and place it, the vibrations will set up, that is transverse wave will pass through this and slightly move the bridges to right hand side as well as left hand side. Please be careful, really very small distance only you have to place. Actually you have to place only one rider between these two. This and this distance exactly at the middle you have to place the rider. Why? Because when it is vibrating you will get a loop here. When fundamental frequency you will get a loop here with two nodes at these two points and anti-node at the middle. Anti-node means with maximum amplitude. There the rider can't stay on the wire, it will fall. So where it is happening, that distance we are measuring as the vibrating length of this tuning fork. So to know that, we are repeating the procedure for different distances as I am separating the light bridges in the same way. Slightly you start separating. And every time you check, there is no vibration since the riders are not vibrating. Gently you have to put it on the length. ఇక్కడ పడుతుంది చూద్దాం. Here, be very careful. See, it started vibrating. And by separating these, once again we'll check this. Is it the correct one or not? At this distance, it is giving fundamental frequency. Once you notice this, you measure the distance from this end to this end. Since these are acting as node points and this center of this is acting as antinode, so here is the fundamental frequency. If you cross this limit, again you will get harmonics. So there also you will get the same thing, right? So in case of harmonics, you will get in between first harmonic, you may get again node points at the midpoint, like that you will get. First you try to find out the fundamental frequency. Thank you. You have to repeat verification of, okay, it is not verification, speed of transverse waves. See, here is the formula, this is the experimental formula. See how you will get experimental formula, I'll show you. See, you will take different tuning forks and with each tuning fork you repeat the same procedure by keeping the tension constant. Well, tension means it is 2000, not 200. It is 200, 2000 multiplied by 980. Give the pins. This is 2000 multiplied by 980, where trial 1 is distance between these two bridges as trial 1. You repeat it the same for the second trial also and take the mean of this and multiply with the frequency with the corresponding length vibrating column. So this product is should be constant, N into L must be constant. Repeat it for different number of tuning forks, frequencies, and find out their resonating segments and find out this root N into L and take one unknown frequency. Unknown means whose frequency is not known to you. That means they'll cover this with something so that it is not visible to you. For that, since frequency is unknown, you write it as X. You don't know. But you repeat the same procedure with the starting point minimum distance and find out the vibrating segment of that particular tuning fork. Find out the L. Then, out of these 5 or 4, you take the average of this N into L constants, and to that average, you multiply, double that. Then so, you will get the velocity of the wave, transverse wave along the stretched string. This is experimental. Then from theoretically, the velocity has a formula under root T by mu, where T is the tension and mu is the linear density. What is meant by linear density? Density per each length of this wire, unit length of the wire, or unit centimeter in case of centimeters. Right? So T we know already, how much is the tension we suspended. How to know linear density? It has a wire, mass of the wire divided by total mass by total length of the wire. So from this we got this as pi r square d, where pi you know already 22/7 or 3.14. R is the radius of the wire. You take one screw gauge and find out first error and do accordingly correction, and then note down the PSR, observed value if there is any correction, corrected value, and then find out the diameter of the wire at 4 different places along the length of the wire, and then take average of the diameter and divide it by 2, you will get radius, which is in millimeters, convert into centimeters since all the other parameters are in centimeters. Once you know that radius value, square it off, and density of the material. Different materials have different densities. The density of brass is 8.5, substitute 8.5 some value. I'll give you the exact value. By substituting all these values, you will get T by nu, whole root you will get velocity, and this should match. And now, how to find out unknown value? You already have the mean value of this unknown tuning fork, and you have root t by L. From this you substitute this, and L is the mean L value where we got the length of the vibrating segment of that unknown tuning fork. By substituting in this formula, by solving, you will get the frequency of the unknown tuning fork. Thank you.